Do not be sorry. Be better.
Don't be sorry. Be better. This quote from Kratos completely shocked me. This simple quote changed my perspective over Kratos. I always had an image of Kratos as a fucking beast who will kill anyone for his benefit, no matter if they deserve or they don't. But God of War 2018 showed us a new image of Kratos. The way this game starts gave me goosebumps. The story from the beginning seemed depressing, and to be true, I shed a drop of tear when we, Kratos and his son, burn the death body of Kratos' wife. This game not only showed us a different personality of Kratos, but this game also showed us a completely new universe of Kratos. The way he handles every situation without getting angry and the way he takes the care of his son told us something important. And that important thing was that the God of War is not that the same hack and slash gaming adventure. Instead, it is a fucking masterpiece which could very well be the game of next decade. But still, whenever I try to finalize on this point, something hits me in my brain, and that is Witcher 3. No matter how many times I try to finalize my decision that God of War is the game of this era, Geralt always appears in my brain and says, "Have you forgot me?" And then I remember all my adventures with Geralt in his mystic world, and if I try to finalize on the decision that Witcher 3 is the game of this era, I always find Kratos saying me that why are you doing this? And this cycle keeps on continuing. And as restricted as I am to finalize my decision because of my two favorite characters, I decided to discuss on that topic with you. So today let's compare both the masterpieces and see whether which game is better than the other. Geralt. Geralt, the main protagonist of this game, is a pale, white, monster hunter witcher who will kill every deserving soul on this planet. And as weak and as small as he seems, he can beat every single soul on this planet with his two swords, one for the monster while the other for humans. He is brave, strong, mentally and physically calm, one of the best swordsmen, and an emotionless witcher. He has a couple of moves in his arsenal, such as magic, healing potion, incredible thinking and unhuman senses, which can also be called Witcher Sense. This sense helps him to see the footprints, smell fragrances and listen to the voices which are far, far, far away. All in all, he has all the traits of Batman, power of Captain America, skills of Deadpool and endurance of a Witcher. Kratos. Kratos, the man with a curse of paleness and red paints all over his body, is a mean, selfish anti-hero who will kill every god for his revenge. He has very well been the face of gaming industry since last 15 years, and although he has always been showed as a merciless killer, but in this game he's a caring father who is struggling from his past, and he will go to all the limits just to save his child. He is one of the gods from Olympus. He is also the child of Zeus, the god of thunder. Kratos can use his blades, thunderbolts, arrows and a lot of different magic powers. Kratos is a bald, huge, powerful character who has escaped the hell for 3 straight times. There is no brainer that Kratos is the more powerful character among Geralt and Kratos himself. The Witcher World. The world of Witcher is based on Eastern Europe. Witcher shows us the long-lost culture and political problems of Europe. Witcher focuses on its world detailing more than the actual character itself. The world of Witcher 3 is carefully crafted from the scratch by CD Projekt Red. All in all, the world of Witcher 3 is beautiful, breathtaking, amazing, highly detailed, and fun to explore around. The God of War World. Although God of War's every title except the latest one have been situated in Olympus, but the latest God of War title is situated in Norse mythology. But due to Witcher being released in 2015, we will compare the world of the latest God of War, which is Asgard. This world is filled with epicness and different things to discover. Although God of War isn't an open world game, but still it offers linear environment in which you can come and go at your own wish. This world is the home of various gods such as Thor, Hela, Loki and Odin, and exploring in this world is nothing short of a treat. We not only get to know about different gods, but we also get to know about their culture. All in all, World of Kratos is good if not great, but when compared to Witcher's world, it falls flat on its head. Combat system of Witcher 3. When it comes to the Witcher 3, it's one of the biggest flaws was its combat system. In Witcher 3, we did had an amazing story, graphics, but the combat system was lackluster at its best. With occasional bugs, not being able to jump and various glitches, the combat system of Witcher 3 was horrible. Combat system of God of War. God of War was never fully known for its combat system, but in the latest edition they changed everything, including combat system, which leads us to the fact that God of War has new combat system. But the main question is it better or is it worse? When it comes to overall combating, you can only do button pressing, whereas in Witcher 3 you had different options of combating, such as using potions, spells, etc. But when it comes to the overall fluidity of the combat system, God of War is better among the two. Not only God of War has an amazing way of switching between axe and hand-to-hand combat, but it provides ultimate satisfaction in those fatalities. Actual questline of Witcher 3. When it comes to the quest, I have never played a better game than Witcher 3. Even their side quests were over the top rope. The sheer amount of content in the quest of Witcher 3 has not been seen by many in many decades. Actual questline of God of War. Although most of the linear games have only one single questline, but God of War 4 did a Prince of Persia Warrior Within style questline, where we can explore the world if we want. When it comes to the quality of quests in God of War, it lacks something, and I can't really figure out whether what it lacks, and maybe I'm finding something lacking because of playing Witcher 3's quests. But whatever the reason is, the side quests of Witcher 3 are much better than God of War for sure. Verdict. Even after this long comparison, I can't really get on one final answer because of the similarities between both the developers. Both Santa Monica and CD Projekt Red have created masterpieces. Both developers didn't include microtransactions, so maybe both the games are the future of gaming, and this puts an example in front of EA that even without microtransactions, you can create awesome games and you can earn shitloads of respect and money at the same time. So guys, that was it from my side. If you liked it, then do press the like button, subscribe the channel and share this video with your friends. I'll catch you in the next one, maybe within a week or two. Till then, peace and enjoy your life, and as always, too sweet.